Hi guys, in today's video we're going to be painting Marnues Augustus Calgar from start to finish. But first of all I want to say a huge thank you to my YouTube channel sponsors Goblin Gaming. If you check the description box down below you'll find a direct link to their web store, and every time you purchase something from that link it greatly helps my YouTube channel. So if you are purchasing anything from Goblin Gaming, please use the link in the description box below. I've painted Marnues Calgar up in a very fetching metallic paint job finish. I think ultramarines look absolutely fantastic with a metallic finish, and I really hope you like this video guys, and if you do please hit the like button. Don't forget to tick the bell symbol as well to make sure you get notified of all future videos that I upload on my channel. Okay guys, this is going to be a long video as always, so go grab yourselves an ice hot drink or maybe an ice cold beer and we'll get started with the tutorial. I start off by priming the miniature using Alclad 2's Lacquer Primer Black. It's important to note that you could use a glossy black primer and get an even more reflective finish to the metallic. I didn't want it to be hyper reflective, so I went for a matte black finish with the primer, but it's up to you what you prefer really. But anyway, it's really important with Alclad lacquer primers to be well ventilated guys. Make sure you're using a good quality airbrush with PTFE solvent proof seals, because it'll damage your airbrush rubber seals if you have those. And I'm working at about 20 psi and about 3 to 4 inches away from the model, just to get a nice even smooth coat. Now we're going to use Ammo of MIG's Warhead Metallic Blue paint. This is going to be the basis of the whole of the miniature really guys. Now it's really important to know with this paint that you don't spray too far away, as what will happen is the metallic flecks will dry mid-air and you'll be left with a grainy texture on the miniature. So you want to spray fairly closely and you want to actually hit it with a fairly heavy coat that's quite wet, so be very careful spraying two thin layers and you'll get a really nice even smooth metallic finish. Now we're going to create some deep shading on the miniature using Games Workshop Shade Paint Null Oil Gloss. It's very important that you use gloss here, because if you use a matte colour it will really spoil the look of the metallics. So we're using the gloss version of Null Oil. What you'll see I'm doing here is going around all the recesses of the miniature and creating that deep shadow that's going to make those panels pop. And here you can see what the miniature looks like after all of the Nornoil gloss had been applied to the miniature. Now we're going to create extreme edge highlighting, also known as hard edge highlighting. We're using Vallejo Game Air Silver here, and all of the very extreme edges of the miniature are going to be highlighted with this Vallejo Game Air Silver. Corn red is the base coat that we're going to use on the cloak and other areas of the miniature, like the rope hanging from his chest. I then wash all the recesses with the Army Painter's purple tone, and all the top folds of the cloak get painted with Games Workshop's Wazdaka red. Vallejo Game Air Wolf Grey is a very, very light grey. It's almost close to white, but it paints on way smoother than most whites that I'm aware of. So this is a great alternative to use to get a really nice, smooth, white looking finish. All the metallics that are due to be painted in gold are going to be base coated using Games Workshop's Balthazar Gold. all the metallics like the guns and the ammo feeds and some other areas on the miniature are going to be painted using Vallejo metal colour gunmetal grey. Here I'm using Broken Toad's Grimy Dirt Pigment. You can use any type of dirt pigment, but I wanted to use a fairly pale one on the cape of Marnues Calgar. And as you can see, I'm just dabbing it on. I added a tiny little bit of ultra matte varnish from AK Interactive to the very bottom of the cloak, so it clumped up the pigments a tiny little bit and gives a really nice texture to the cloak. Games Workshop Xandri Dust is painted on the base. Games Workshop's Norn Oil is going to be painted on all of the silver metallics that were painted on Marnues Calgar. Now this is going to create a really nice contrast between the really highly reflective metallics and these being very dull in colour. I wanted to keep the highly reflective properties of the metallics, and to do this we're going to use Agrax Earthshade Gloss. Again, it's important to note that we're using a fairly small brush and I'm not oversaturating the model with wash, as I don't want it to pull too much. Games Workshop's Liberator Gold is going to be painted onto all of the gold metallics. What we're going to do is create highlights, so we're just going to look for all the raised surfaces of the gold. The army painter's flesh tone is washed onto the base. And here we have our finished Marnues Calgar. Now there's a few things I forgot to film during this tutorial, guys. One of them was painting the tassels or the pelt hanging from the torso of Marnues Calgar, and I base coated it using Mournfang Brown, and then I used XV88 to hard edge highlight it. Well, anyway, I really hope you've enjoyed this video, guys, and if you have, please hit the like button. Don't forget to share it amongst friends also. I want to say a huge thank you once again to Goblin Gaming, my YouTube channel sponsors. Don't forget to check that description box below to links to their web store. And thank you very much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.